we'll start in several minutes. Just wait for a few minutes and we'll start the event, okay?
More minutes, guys, okay? Because we have some technical issues, and at the same time, some students are usually late, so it's a bonus for both of us. Thank you.
program in non-EU countries. And today I will speak more about Erasmus exchange for studies in European Union, in non-European Union, and also bilateral exchange. Yeah, I think that you all gathered here to get more information about possibilities to go abroad. So, and most probably you also, you have checked the competitions which are announced, so I'm just repeating a bit. So that now we have a competition for exchange studies with Erasmus and bilateral exchange in non-EU countries, then Erasmus exchange studies in EU countries, also Erasmus student or recent graduate traineeship competition, and in EU countries, in non-EU countries, with the other scholarships, and the last one, Thomas will tell more about it because it's new for me as well. Okay, so first of all, when you think about going abroad, you need to think about this destination, where you want to go, how to choose the country, the university, right? So there are like most important tips what you should check before applying and before going abroad. So of course, the first of all, the attractiveness of the university and the suitability of study programs. So when you are selecting the university and the country, you have to see if you will find the subjects that you can take in that university and which will be recognized after your return here in at VMU. Then of course it's very important to see how the life is going there and if you will have a possibility to live in a student's dormitory or you need to find another place for staying, how much it costs, what is the economic situation in that country. Because let's say in one country it's cheaper and the scholarship which you're getting from the funds will be quite enough to stay in that country, and in some other countries the scholarship might cover only, I don't know, 50%, 40% of all the expected expenses. So yeah, you should check these things before applying for exchange. And of course the cultural differences are also quite important, so you should see if everything is acceptable for you. And first I'll talk about Erasmus studies in European Union. Yeah, so the main thing that for Erasmus program, in total you have 12 months during one study level. Let's say if now you are a bachelor student and you are planning to go with Erasmus scholarship for studies or traineeship, so you should know that you have 12 months in total in bachelor studies. Let's say you can go for studies for two semesters because usually one semester is from 4 to 5 months. So let's say if you were for exchange, for studies, like for 8 months, so you still have 3-4 months left for Erasmus traineeship or vice versa. So yeah, you should know that. And Erasmus scholarship for studies is given from 3 to 6 months. So it's one semester, usually, as I mentioned, around 4 or 5 months. And if you are going only for final thesis writing and you are not taking any courses, just doing the research, getting the consultations with the teachers, then you have 3 months for staying in abroad in that university. Where you can apply, so it's in appas.erasmus.vdu.lt, you will find all the applications. and the application deadline is October 4. When you are applying for Erasmus in EU countries, you can select up to 5 universities in your application. So of course you have to list them by priority. What is important? Important is the language knowledge. In most universities, the subjects for foreign students are taught in English, but in some universities it might differ. Let's say in France or in Spain, sometimes the subjects are taught only in Spanish or in French. So you need to check these things also before applying. And of course, if you have that language knowledge, you can apply freely. As I mentioned before, you have to check if your study program matches with the one which is offered abroad, in partner university. And the last thing what you will need to do is to write a short motivation letter, and you will have to include it to the application form. And then you apply until October 4, and the faculties are making the student selection, and the results will be announced in October 13. Okay, so this is about the EU universities, and here you can see the scholarships. So there are four groups of countries, and scholarships differ, so you can see it here. And what is important to mention that for socially disadvantaged students, there is an additional scholarship, 200 euros per month, and also the additional scholarship is for students with the special needs. So after the selection, you will talk with your coordinator and you will get more information about it. The next program is exchange studies in non-EU countries. So here is the competition announced together for Erasmus and bilateral exchange in non-EU countries. So we are announcing this competition together for Erasmus and bilateral exchange because a bigger part of our partners, our universities, they give the same opportunities, right? And for this you have to apply in the same place, also campus/medical.org. And what is the selection criteria? They are quite similar. So study compatibility, your results of study. For bilateral exchange, the results from last two semesters, your GPA cannot be lower than 8. Erasmus doesn't have this requirement, but still it is quite important. Also, as I mentioned, the good knowledge of foreign language in which the subjects are taught in foreign university, so it is also very important. And your motivation. You will have to write also a short motivation letter, and you will have to include it to the application form. During this selection, you can choose up to 3 universities, and there will be a committee from all university, and selection will be like centralized. It will be organized by international cooperation department, and if there will be any other details and more interesting and more bigger competitions in one another country. So you might be invited for interview with a committee. So, but in any case, the results should be announced in October 13. So please prepare applications and apply. And grants, so you can see that if you get the Erasmus grant, so scholarship is the same to any country, so it's 700 euros per month. It doesn't matter if you're going, let's say, to Argentina, to United States, or to Japan. Additionally, you will receive here the travel grant, which is different, which depends on the distance between Lithuania, Kaunas, and the city of the hosting university. Also, yes, additional scholarship is given for students with a special disability, special needs. And the annual mobility scholarship is also differs for the country, so you can see the list of regions here. So what I also would like to mention that you can apply for all, let's say, for both competitions at once. You can apply for Erasmus in EU, Erasmus non-EU, and also for traineeships. Okay, so thank you. If you have any questions about studies abroad, you can ask me after this presentation. And now I'm inviting my colleague Thomas. He will speak about traineeships.
Hello everyone. I'm going to talk a lot, so I'm going to prepare some water from the beginning. So I'm going to talk about traineeships. But first of all, I just want to take this moment and appreciate it, because, you know, for the last probably couple of years, we've been talking to the screen, you know, not seeing student faces, not having any live events around the university. So let's not take it for granted, you know. Let's make sure each other's safety, you know, and appreciate the moments that we have now. It's really great to have you all here, and, you know, to have all these events taking place in the university right now. So thank you for joining us. Let's talk traineeships. What is traineeship? It's pretty much fancier word for internship, actually. So if you know what internship is, you know what traineeship is as well. Let's talk Erasmus traineeship program. Why is it special? Why it's important? Erasmus traineeship program is the most popular and the most flexible program for students, because it is the most popular program among the students as well. So what possibilities does Erasmus traineeship offer to the students? Erasmus traineeship program has two different, let's say, possibilities. One is for student traineeship, and another one is for recent graduate traineeship. So what is the student traineeship? Student traineeships are traineeships that are being carried out during your study cycles. Let's say you have you're studying political science, like I was, you know, I used to study political science here. So you can have your student traineeship during your free time from studies, usually during the winter or summer breaks, or if you manage, you know, to coordinate all your subjects. Let's say nowadays you can have your subjects online, you can, you know, coordinate them and have, let's say, a traineeship during your semester. But usually, traineeships for students are being carried out during your free time. So take a note of that. And regarding the recent graduate traineeship, why this program is special? Because do we have any last year students here? No, but we will have in a few years, I guess. So take a note about this, because recent graduate traineeship is for students who are last year students, and they want to have a traineeship after their graduation date. So recent graduate traineeship starts after you graduate. So you, when you apply, you have to apply while you are still a student. So during your last year, you can apply for recent graduate traineeship and then go for a traineeship in a year after your graduation date. And you can decide when you want to go. Just, you know, you have to do it in 1 year. After 1 year, you lose this possibility. So make sure to note that. So Erasmus traineeship. Why it is Erasmus? It's mostly for European Union. So for studies, you can go for Erasmus outside of EU. For traineeships, that Erasmus traineeships only in EU and only in European Economic Area zone. So that's the countries that belong to this program. The ratio of the traineeship is from 2 to 6 months, but if you want to, you can actually extend your traineeship period up to 12 months. And the traineeship placement, actually can be any legally registered organization, company, community, NGOs, anything that is legally registered. So anything that is related to your study field, it can work as a traineeship placement. You just have to be legally registered, company, organization. And the most important thing about the traineeship placement point, that you have to find a traineeship placement by yourself. So you have to do your research, find a traineeship placement, and you know, get acceptance from them. It's like an acceptance form that you have to get in order to apply. So this is how it works. It might sound really difficult process, but it actually not, because there are plenty of websites offering traineeship placements in all of the Europe, you know, like erasmusintern.org or trainingexperience.com. There are plenty of those websites. Also, you can always contact me. I can give you some suggestions that students have been already, you know, and give you some contacts or some information where you can find the traineeship placement. So it's up to you to decide. And actually, it's the best part of the program, because only you know where you want to have your traineeship. You want to know where you want to go, you know, what skills to gain. So that's the, I think, the best part of the program. Also, very important thing to mention about the traineeship placement, that all EU organizations, official organizations like that belong to the European Union, cannot be suitable for traineeship placement. So let's say European Parliament, Commission, and other institutions that are from European Union cannot be placement. So all other organizations can, but you know, those that are from European Union institutions that cannot be the placements for your traineeship. Very important thing for student traineeships, that traineeships can be recognized as a subject in your curriculum. Let's say you are a second year student, you're studying political science, and you know you have a, let's say, a traineeship, internship subject in your curriculum in the third year of your studies. So you can go for Erasmus traineeship during your summer after the second year, and you can get your internship recognized, Erasmus traineeship recognized as an internship subject you have in the third year, and you won't have to do a boring internship here in Lithuania, let's say, like I did in the municipality, which was really boring. So do Erasmus research and go for Erasmus training. It's simple. And actually a very nice part of the Erasmus traineeship and other traineeship programs, that you can get a paid traineeship. So you can get a scholarship from university, from Erasmus program, and you can get paid from the traineeship placements. Paid traineeships, like getting a more in the European Union, so more and more traineeship placements are paying the trainees, because you know, in order to get quality trainee, you have to give some bonuses to them. So that's like one of the best parts of the program as well. And scholarship, all of the students who will go for Erasmus traineeships are usually provided with scholarships, monthly scholarships for up to 6 months. If you extend your traineeship, you can get even a scholarship for 12 months as well. So it is important for you. Let's talk about application documents and application process. Actually, application process is rather easy, actually. All you have to do, you have to have a traineeship placement, like I have mentioned. You have to get the acceptance letter from the company organizations that accepts you. And, you know, with the document that you have, you have to fill an application form, write a short motivational letter, fill the data blanks, you know, about yourself, and then attach the document. This works for student traineeship. Meanwhile, for recent graduate traineeship, you have to do the same process. You have to be last year student, and you have to get the recommendations from a faculty member. You have to get like one recommendations from someone from the faculty. It could be wise dean, it could be a dean, it could be a professor, it could be your supervisor of your, let's say, final thesis. You have to get one recommendation from a faculty member that you are recommended for the program. And application deadline is actually coming soon, but don't worry about that, because we have competitions for Erasmus traineeships taking place each month. So all those competitions will take place each month until June 2022, when the last competition will take place, and you know, the summer will start. And selection process. For student traineeship, selection is being made by your faculty members, because they know you. And there are a couple like priorities given to students who have never been on an Erasmus program before, and to those students who have an internship subject in their curriculum. But if you don't apply to those, like if you have find a suitable traineeship placement related to your study field, I'm pretty sure you're going to be selected for the program. Also important is great motivation, language knowledge, experience, problem solving skills, and study results. But don't worry about the study results that much. You know, there is no like particular criteria for your grades, but you know, the better study results you have, the better for yourself. Well, always, but you know, there are no particular requirement for this. And let's talk about scholarships. The scholarship size is actually a bit more generous than for study exchange, but you have to note, because you know, when you go for a traineeship, usually you won't be offered like accommodation in a student dormitory or you know, other bonuses from, let's say, other universities. So you'll have to do a lot of things yourself, but sometimes companies help with accommodation and other things. So scholarship sizes are here. There are additional scholarships for students with special needs and little scholarship bonus for disadvantaged students. So let's move on. And you know, students always ask me, you know, can I go to for a traineeship in, let's say, USA? It's one of the most popular destinations among the students. Yes, actually you can. It's not with the Erasmus program, but this is a program with mobility scholarship coming from Vytautas Mažvydas University. So there is this possibility. This program is only for students. There is no recent graduate traineeship program with this program, so you can go only as a student. So make sure to use this possibility while you're still a student. It only works in non-EU and EEA countries, so all the countries that belong to the Erasmus program doesn't belong to this program. So it works like an opposite. And for, you know, for traineeship period, it's from 1 to 3 months. It's more flexible, so you can have, let's say, a traineeship during January for 1 month, and that's enough. Meanwhile, for Erasmus, the minimum period of traineeship is 2 months. So take a note of that. And the traineeship is supposed to end until the end of academic year. So until the end of next summer, you're supposed to end this traineeship. Traineeship placements, you have to find it yourself. It's a bit harder because the world is bigger than EU, you know, but it's possible, you know, so everything depends on you. In this case, I can help you less because I have less connections and all over the globe, but you know, I can at least try to help you if you need some help. Also, the traineeships could be paid traineeships, so this is important. Scholarships are provided. We'll talk about the scholarship sizes a little bit later. And the important thing that also this program can be recognized as a traineeship internship subject that you have in your curriculum. So you can go for this program as well and come back with and get credits for it. So you won't have to take internship here in Lithuania. Selection criteria is very, very similar, but I want to point out that your grades cannot be lower than 8. For the last 2 semesters, your grade average have to be above 8, because if it's lower, below 8, you cannot go for this program, because this program is funded by university itself. It's not coming from Erasmus or other funding, so we try to select only like the best students, you know, to represent us, so you know, and the scholarship number is limited, so take a note of that. Other requirements are very similar, and the application deadline is October 31st. And the scholarship sizes, I divided in two groups, and we are offering usually around 10 scholarships a year, but usually that's enough. This program is known for those students that are particularly interested in some particular organizations or country, you know, so usually 10 scholarships is enough. And the last but not least, traineeship program in organizations for economic cooperation and development. Let's call it OECD. This program is very new for us. We have signed an agreement with OECD like 2 years ago, and it's like a very prestigious international organization that you probably all know. Probably one of the most prestigious international organizations in the world, and when you students have a chance to have a traineeship there. So how it works? You have to be a student, so it's only student traineeship. You have to be enrolled as a student, so you have to be studying while doing your traineeship at OECD. Traineeship field is for all social sciences, so let's say law, political sciences, all marketing, economics, finance, and other similar sciences, for IT field and for natural sciences as well. So this is not the main field, study fields that they are looking for in interns, but you know, if you're studying other things, you can also look into this possibility. Maybe they are also looking for interns in this, your study. Competition, it works, it happens only once a year. Students have to submit their applications until October 1st, and then we'll have a selection process. Selection process is rather, not, I won't say difficult, but it's actually challenging because you have to go through two selection processes. One selection process is done by us. We'll select up to 15 students. We'll send a shortlist to the OECD, and then they'll do their own selection process, which is rather challenging because you will have to do an interview and we'll have to do a test. But you know, if you're really motivated, you're looking for a possibility to work, to have an internship in this kind of prestigious organizations, you can do it. I believe in you. So this is how it works. Traineeship durations from 1 to 6 months, but they're looking usually for students who can have like a traineeship for at least like several months, because you know, it takes some time to, you know, to teach the intern some basics. And you actually have to prepare, have to be prepared for quite a few hours of work, because they're looking for 40 hours a week, like a traineeship. So you have to work, do an internship, let's say around 8 hours a day. So you have to be really determined, you know, to do your studies at the same time and like do internship at OECD. And scholarships, they also are providing students with scholarships, which is around 700 euros per month. And you would be most likely be going to Paris to work for them. But there are also there are other subdivisions in Europe, let's say in Berlin and other cities. But most likely you would go to Paris because it's the biggest division of OECD in Europe. And usually they have, at once they usually have around 500 interns. So lots of interns like taking place there. Normally they are having lots of interns, and you have to know, be competitive, you know, how to really want to, you know, to get the possibility to have an internship there. So this is pretty much it from my side. And if you have any questions now, you can ask me or other coordinators, you know, for answers, and we'll gladly answer. If you want to know, have more personal communication, you know, have a personal meeting tomorrow, we can have a, you know, Erasmus coffee meeting from tomorrow and Thursday, so you can see us tomorrow. But I would suggest, you know, to ask questions now, and you know, if you want to learn some tips or recommendations, come tomorrow. So feel free to ask. And after actually event, we'll have your emails. So we'll send you like a short evaluation form that you will evaluate us, you know, our presentation, if it was fun, nice, good or bad, you know, what we were lacking, you know, so you will have a chance to, you know, to give us improvement of our presentation for the next time. Please feel free, you can ask in Lithuanian, you can ask in English, we'll gladly answer all of your questions. Don't be shy, don't be like most of Lithuanians, they are always shy, you know, don't be like that. You know. You will overcome that eventually, so don't be like that. Or if you want, you can always come to visit us tomorrow, so there's no pressure.
I wanted to ask you
about
the program. I mean, you can go for a exchange, right?
Yes.
But can you also go for a trainership?
Actually, you can go for several mobilities during your study cycles.
Oh.
But you, for Erasmus, you have 12 months for mobility. So you can have two traineeships, one study abroad. You can have like three traineeships, no study exchange. You can have three short study exchange and then one traineeship. So, you know, it actually, you can combine everything. Just, you know, two mobilities cannot overlap at the same time. So make sure to finish your studies exchange and then go for a traineeship or vice versa. But very like no important thing to do, like a good like a recommendation from our side, you can always go for a study exchange, and while you are studying, let's say in Spain, you really enjoy your time there, you can find a traineeship placement and apply for a traineeship while you are still there, and then you know when your study exchange ends, you can stay in Spain and you have your traineeship there. So like you can combine many things. Let's say you have your study exchange during the spring semester next year, and then you really enjoy your time there. You can apply for a traineeship during the summer and stay there longer. So combine many things. Just just make sure during one study cycle not to exceed 12 months of Erasmus mobility. While for the new mobility scholarship, there is no limit. You can go for as many mobilities as you want.
If your faculty allows you to go.
But they really do, so take a chance. Also, as my colleague mentioned, you can apply for several applications at once. So you see, you can apply for non-EU, also EU study exchange, and apply for a traineeship at the same time. So you can get selected even for several mobility, but then you will have to choose where to go. And for
I wanted to ask, so the deadlines are for the fall semester, right?
It's
right now.
It's for spring semester.
Oh, for spring semester.
Yes, for spring semester. And in non-EU countries, there are several universities for next autumn. Yeah, so you can.
Yeah, also about that, I saw that there were only, I think, 3 or 4 countries
mm-hmm.
for the autumn.
Yes. So there will be the main competition for the next autumn will be announced in February.
Oh.
So you will have to apply then, but there are several universities which application deadlines are very early, so we are making those.
But it's it's possible to apply later, right?
Yes.
Go in next year.
Yes, of course, you can apply in February and there will be the whole long list of the universities for the next.
Also important thing to mention is when you have those, as I mentioned, 12 months for Erasmus per cycle. So you have 12 months for bachelor degree, 12 months for master's degree, and 12 months for PhD studies. So you know, when you go to the upper level, you know, it restarts, so you have plenty of possibilities. Just for you to know, it's basics. Any other questions? Please.
Can I go for a traineeship so it can be recognized as my minor study?
If you have a internship subject in your minor studies, then yes, just make sure that the traineeship field is related to your minor studies. Please.
Publicity is just for last year students?
No, it's for all the students. You have to be a student to apply. Well, if you don't have any other questions, please, those who haven't registered online, please register here. And then I'm going to invite you for a trip around Kaunas. You'll have a ESN organizing a trip around Kaunas, so you get to know Kaunas if you're not from Kaunas here. And see you tomorrow, maybe come for a coffee. Let's talk about some tips, recommendations, maybe cheating strategies, how to know to improve your application, mention your motivation letters, all those things, to be discussed next to a cup of coffee. So. Also, make sure to come tomorrow to listen to other students' presentations. They will share their experiences, how they handle their study exchange or traineeships. No? They will have some foreign students representing the programs from even abroad because they have done their traineeships or study exchange living abroad now. Maybe they will share experience. Also, on Thursday, we'll have students' presentations. Incoming students, so the students who came to Lithuania, they will represent their countries, their universities, and their lifestyles and everything. Make sure to participate in the events. And tomorrow we have a movie night, so also join us for the events. Thank you for coming.